There are more yellow-legged frogs in this cooler than there are adults existing in the wild. And it's one of the most endangered amphibians on the planet. There are only a handful of frogs left in the wild in this canyon. I was really excited to get the Los Angeles Zoo involved in this particular population because the San Gabriel Mountains is Los Angeles, so this is kind of LA's frog.
To get this much excitement from a frog is really, really a cool thing. Today was a real big milestone in the frog program, the conservation of the mountain yellow-legged frog. It's really great to see all these agencies looking at recovering this really critically endangered species. You know, without this frog, there's no other frogs in the high elevation sites.
You take anything out of nature's equation, there's an impact on the cycle. If you want to put it in the perspective of what does it do for human beings, right? Well, you know, it's millions of less mosquitoes when the yellow-legged frogs are living in these canyons.
4 or 5 years ago, we collected tadpoles from the site, brought them to the LA Zoo, where the LA Zoo staff did an incredible job breeding them.
We received about 20 tadpoles from each canyon. It took them about 2 years to complete metamorphosis, and then about another year to become adult reproductive sized frogs. Amphibians in general are more difficult to care for in captivity because there's less room for error, especially a species like the mountain yellow-legged frog that comes from this pristine mountain habitat. You know, on a scale of 1 to 10, they're probably a 9.5 when it comes to husbandry skill. So we have a biosecure room where we raise just mountain yellow-legged frogs, and we replicate their complete photo cycle for 1 year, their temperature cycle for a year, so we get them down close to freezing. These animals would be experiencing snow in the winter, right? We do everything from stepping the light down every day as we go into fall, and then stepping it back up into the springtime. These are the critical things that are needed to reproduce sensitive species like Rana muscosa, mountain yellow-legged frog. So those 20 frogs, I should say 40 frogs collectively, were responsible for about 2,500 offspring. I think one of the reasons we've been so successful with this frog is that we have this amazingly talented staff at Los Angeles Zoo. We've developed a lot of different techniques for reproducing environmental parameters that the frogs need, and we've done that for a lot of different species and been able to kind of integrate that into our Rana muscosa program. And we couldn't have done it without all our great partners too, USGS, Fish and Wildlife, Fish and Game, etc.
So today we were releasing tadpoles that were produced in captivity at the Los Angeles Zoo.
The frogs need 55 degree temperature water. What we've done is we've got some very specialized coolers and backpack coolers that we put bags of tadpoles in.
The site we're releasing them is not vehicle accessible, and so we had to hike in. Once we got to the release site, you know, we had to acclimate the tadpoles into the ponds we were releasing them.
We float them in the stream bed for about 20 minutes, and once they reach temperature, kind of an equilibrium, we go ahead and just simply release them back into nature. Today we released 500 tadpoles.
The release went exceptionally well. Everything looked great. We're pretty excited. You know, I've been working with the species for 18 years. And to finally get to the point where, you know, actually doing on the ground recovery is really, you know, exciting and rewarding. So it's a really good feeling. It's really nice.
Ton of satisfaction. You know, you feel really good about what you're doing when you can, you know, raise something in a captive situation and bring it back and watch it swim off into nature. Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it's fantastic.
Bringing the frog back will really restore, you know, the natural system here.